Want to get a pay raise without doing anything at all? Like the idea of living off of safe, growing, passive dividend income? Would you like to know about stocks that are now paying out even bigger dividends than they were before? Then you have to check out today's video.
He is a best-selling author.
30-year-old Jason Fieber has a plan.
This guy retired at only 33 years old.
I don't know if I know too many people that have accomplished something like that.
He's really kind of a guru when it comes to passive income.
Before I get into today's content, please give us a big thumbs up if you find value in our videos. Helps us to get the word out and grow the channel, and I'd really appreciate it. Dividend growth investing. It's the gift that keeps on giving. Actually, it's better than that because the gifts, the dividends, get bigger and bigger year in and year out. That's right, the growth in dividend growth investing is all about those growing dividends. Dividends all by themselves are fantastic. I mean, who doesn't want to wake up to fresh new money they didn't go to sleep with? But because inflation causes the costs of life to slowly rise over time, you have to make sure that your passive income can keep up with that. That's where the dividend increases come in. Many high quality dividend growth stocks are growing their dividends at rates that exceed inflation. And that means your purchasing power slowly expands over time. Today, I want to tell you about three dividend growth stocks that just increased their dividends. Ready? Let's dig in. The first dividend increase I want to tell you about came from First Source Corporation, stock ticker SRCE. First Source just increased their dividend by 3.3%. 3.3% doesn't sound like much, but check this out. This is the third time they've increased their dividend this year. That's right, three dividend declarations in 2021, three dividend increases. How can you not love that? This is the 34th consecutive year of dividend increases for the regional bank. First Source is a very small bank in the Midwestern USA with a market cap of right about $1 billion, but don't let its size fool you. Their 10-year dividend growth rate is a very strong 10.3%, and that comes on top of the stock's market-beating yield of 2.8%. This is a nice combination of yield and growth. Like many banks, this stock's valuation is very reasonable. Despite the consistent business growth and 34 consecutive years of dividend raises, the stock looks pretty cheap. The price-to-earnings ratio is under 11, which is obviously well below the broader market's earnings multiple, and the price-to-book ratio at 1.2 is well below its five-year average of 1.5. If your portfolio has room for a small regional bank, this name is interesting. Let's now talk about the dividend increase that came in from McKesson Corporation, stock ticker MCK.
McKesson just increased their dividend by 11.9%.
Yeah, the prices of goods and services are up in 2021. What's new? That's inflation. But when you have dividend growth stocks like McKesson handing out near 12% increases in your income, who cares? This is the beauty of dividend growth investing. Inflation causes a licking, but you keep on ticking.
This marks the 15th consecutive year of dividend increases for the pharmaceutical distributor.
This near 12% dividend increase matches up very nicely with their 10-year dividend growth rate, which is 11%. Of course, with the stock's yield of 0.8%, you need some serious dividend growth to rationalize the investment. Shareholders have got to be happy with that kind of boost in their dividend income.
The stock is up 16% year to date, but the valuation remains undemanding.
The price to cash flow ratio at 7.2 is below its own five-year average of 7.5, and the stock's current yield, while low, is not far off from its own recent historical average. I wouldn't say the stock is an absolute steal or anything like that, but it's not exactly expensive either. Last but not least, let's have a conversation about the dividend increase that came in from Stanley Black & Decker, Inc., stock ticker SWK.
Stanley Black & Decker just increased their dividend by a whopping 12.9%.
Boy, this is the kind of stuff that just gives me those warm and fuzzy feelings. Passive income is awesome, but a near 13% bump in passive income for doing nothing other than holding stock? That's phenomenal. Being a dividend growth investor is the best, easiest, most rewarding, and most enjoyable job I've ever had.
The tool manufacturer has now increased its dividend for 55 consecutive years.
This isn't just a dividend aristocrat, it's a dividend king, which is a title conferred to those stocks with 50 or more consecutive years of dividend increases. Think about everything that's happened over the last 55 years. Wars, recessions, massive disruptions, even a global pandemic. Yet this company kept on pumping out a bigger dividend year in and year out. This latest dividend increase actually shows a very nice dividend growth acceleration off of the 10-year dividend growth rate of 6.5%. And the stock even yields a pretty decent 1.5%.
The stock is up 22% year to date, but the valuation hasn't become extreme at all.
The valuation here looks neither low nor high to me. Basically, I think you're paying a fair price for a great business. As Warren Buffett has rightfully noted before, it's better to pay a fair price for a wonderful business than a wonderful price for a fair business. The price-earnings ratio at 21 is lower than its five-year average of 23.8. Other metrics like the price-to-sales ratio show some slight overvaluation, and the 1.5% yield is 20 basis points lower than the stock's five-year average. Overall, this is a dividend king that should continue to perform very well for many years to come.
Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Give us a like if you did, and let us know in the comments what you think about these dividend increases. Please make sure to subscribe to the channel and ring that notification bell so that you don't miss out on new content. Also, take a look at the description box below for some important links, including the link to my personal stock portfolio. This six-figure portfolio, which I call the Fire Fund, generates enough passive dividend income for me to live off of. It allowed me to retire in my early 30s. I've made my portfolio entirely accessible over a Patreon, and I also post alerts there whenever I buy or sell stock. I put my money where my mouth is, and I'm often invested in the same high-quality dividend growth stocks that I make videos on. Over the years, I've heard from thousands of investors who have been profiting from many of the same exact stocks that I own. So if you think this is something that you could benefit from as well, check the link in the description to see my portfolio and start getting my buy and sell alerts. I'll see you next time.